We're asking coaches to talk a little bit about their teams as we get ready for camp with the players reporting next week. Got a lot of guys coming back. You've reached the national championship game, but give us a little update on your squad.
Well, everybody's got a lot of guys coming back, but we're excited. We're excited the step we took this spring in terms of getting to Frisco. Obviously disappointed in the results, but it's, in our opinion, my opinion, it's motivational. Excited about the fall. We're not trying to create new formulas and all that stuff. We take care of our guys. We ask them all the time how they're doing, and we will make the right decisions and plan to have a great fall. And feel we're honored to be picked number one, but with that comes some responsibility to play great football, and we'll do that.
Thank you, Coach. And again, media, if you have a question for Coach John Stiegelmeier, raise your hand or use your reactions button. We'll start off with Zach.
John, Zach Borg with Dakota News Now. You kind of just mentioned it, but getting picked first for the first time in program history, I know you probably don't want the players to look too much into that, but still it is kind of a neat benchmark for your program, isn't it, to reach this? You certainly would rather be picked first every year than anywhere else.
Number one, it's great to have high expectations, and when you're picked number one, it verifies the expectations you have in your program. So we have great leadership. Our guys will approach it right. They always have. And we're honored, but we need to, like I said earlier, we need to respond to that. Who's the little guy or little gal? Who is that again?
It's Dean. It's in his contract for year two that I include him in a few of these things.
I appreciate that.
One more question. Obviously, that everybody's wondering about what the quarterback situation is going to look like. This will be your third straight year with a new starting QB. I know Keaton's back. You've got the transfer, Oladokun, some freshmen. How does the quarterback situation look?
You know, I think it's fine. It's different than we anticipated. Obviously, we're down our top two quarterbacks in Mark and Jabore. Chris has been a great addition. He's done a great job of jumping in and leading in a unique situation for us. I believe in Keaton. I believe in Rudy. I believe in our true freshmen. And, Chris is only going to have been here 2 months, so we'll see how he responds to the pressure of fall camp.
All right, Kelly.
Hey, Coach Jake, how are you?
I'm super, Kelly. How are you?
I'm good. How have you reflected on the what-ifs from the national title game to make you and your coaching staff better heading into this fall?
Well, there's a lot of them. You know the game of football that play here, play there. In answer to your question specifically, I watched the game again last week. I literally made comments just in the first quarter. I watched the whole game, but the number of plays in the first quarter that you forget would have impacted the game. And we're going to have a period during practice that we're going to call 23-21. That was the score of the game, to remind our guys how fickle the game is and how hard it is to play perfect, and we're going to grade that period, whatever the practice is, no pads, whatever, and try to get that mentality that you have to make that play at any time in the game. So, but again, really proud of our program.
Yeah, I love that idea. Arguably your team handled COVID, or I should say managed COVID, maybe better than any team in the conference in the spring. How do you have that success with managing players that choose to be unvaccinated?
You know, that's an interesting question, because I think it's come back to bite us, to be honest with you, because we have the lowest percentage of guys vaccinated in the Missouri Valley Football Conference. And I think it's caused our guys to say, hey, we did it without a vaccine. We can maybe do it. And I say maybe. And so we're really pushing hard here at the end to get our guys vaccinated. Bottom line is, if they're not vaccinated, they're going to be treated like they were last year, with masks and to-go meals and those types of things, and not as punishment, but as that's the way life was and that's the way life is. And I think our guys will respond like they always do, and we'll get to that 85%. But we're a long ways off.
Thanks, Coach.
You bet.
And Sean.
Hey, Coach. Sean Bauer, KLN News. At the end of the season, you had talked about how you're going to give the guys some extra time off if they needed it. Did any players take advantage of that just to kind of get a mental break with the short turnaround?
Interesting question. our big guys, I normally call them fat guys, but I'll call them big guys today. Our big guys, the D-line and the O-line, were there day one. I would say 98% of them. The skill guys chose, many of them chose to take some extra time off. And why is that? I don't know. But they were at workouts today, and I'm guessing we have 98% of our guys all here now. And so, to me, the way we practiced and with the spring, it wasn't the physical part of it. It was the mental part of it. And that's why I made that decision to give them some extra time off. It wasn't the physical part. It was to get away and be who they are without football for a while.
Physically, how does the team kind of feel? I know hearing from them a few weeks ago, they talked about how they were more in game shape than they ever have been just because of the short turnaround.
Their interpretation of game shape and mine is a little different. We got some work to do, I think, in terms of conditioning, but in terms of attitude and energy and commitment, it's been tremendous. So I know our strength coach, Nate Moe, will do what he needs to do during fall camp to get him into game shape. But right now, I think we're a little off of that.
How are you feeling about your depth? Obviously, you get a lot of freshmen that probably got some action in the spring that maybe they wouldn't have last fall. Does that make you guys a deeper team heading into this season?
Well, there's two things that make us a deeper team. First of all, the freshmen that got all those reps and, like many coaches have said, played some football in the spring. But then again, we have 12 super seniors, if you will, coming back to play. 10 of those guys are starters. So I think for all of us, this is a unique time in history of college football that you have this situation. And it's not like you have to come up with a new formula. You're going to play the best guys. But again, it's the best depth we'll ever have.
Jeff.
Piggybacking on that question, it seems like in the league there's an amazing number of six-year seniors. How will that impact or could impact the league race?
Well, assuming we are all good coaches, you put your players in a position to win the football game, the better players you have, the better chance you have. And a six-year senior is, in my opinion, infinitely better than a true freshman or a redshirt freshman. So, this is a fickle game, and those guys with a lot of experience handle that part of the game a lot better. They're ready to make that play at any time in the game than a young guy is. And so I think it'll impact it in a great way. But again, we all have those guys, so who knows? I think it's going to be a unique race with all the veterans we have coming back in all our programs. You bet.
Hey, Coach. This is Daniel Rodriguez with This League with Daniel. I wanted to ask you about your running back, Pierre Strong, named first-team all-conference today. Just what does he mean to the program, and what is there any expectations that you see from him this season?
Well, Pierre's, number one, a great leader. He's a great person, and he's obviously a really good football player. Expectations would be take the next step. God's given him a lot of ability. He's got to figure out how to squeeze a little bit more out of that body and his techniques and so on. One of the unique things for Pierre is he's on his fourth position coach in 4 years. And so that, I think, can be good, and it could be a little tough. Andre Crenshaw, the coach we hired, I think is going to do a great job of handling Pierre. And Pierre wants to play in the NFL, so every play for him is an audition. He'll put his signature on it.
All right, Andrew.
Hey, John. Some of the other coaches talked about having some health specialists or other people come in and talk about vaccinations. Have you done any of that?
We have not. We're going to do it at the start of fall camp. I would say I'm a little late on that. I just thought common sense says, we have this term in our program, team first, and we have another term that says leave nothing to chance. And in my opinion, those two terms intersect to say get vaccinated. And our players have not, to my disappointment, have not responded that way. So it's their decision. I'll honor that, but we're going to do what we can here moving forward and try to get up to 85%.
Thanks, Andrew. And Coach, we'll wrap it up with Dom Izzo. Dom?
Stay, good to hear from you. I'm curious, can you tell us what was Mark's exact injury and how frustrating is it to have it come, obviously, when it did, but have the season he had derail what could have happened this fall?
I cannot comment on his exact injury. I can tell you he's out for a year. He will not play this season. Won't practice for a long time. And so a serious injury. Twofold question. The impact it had in the football game was surely disappointing. But again, I think you've heard me say this. We have that. We don't use the term next man up. We use the term believe in your student athletes. And so when you put a guy out there, you ideally he feels and you've prepared him to win the football game for us. And I think Keaton Hyde felt that. We just didn't get it done. We had a chance to win it. We didn't get it done. And so obviously the loss of Mark was tough. But we had a lot of guys that were healthy and could have made those plays like I talked about earlier.
How's the team, I guess, mentally recovering from that, knowing that Mark's not going to be available for the fall?
Again, they reflect our coaches' opinions, and they really believe in the guys we have. I think guys have bought into Chris Oladokun, our transfer. They believe in Keaton Heidi. The young guys are still learning. So we don't play in the past here. We play in the present, and I think we'll move ahead. I know this. Mark is out there every day on his crutches leading still, and so really an inspiration for our football team.